Good morning. It's Thursday, the 9th of February, 2017. Welcome along to this morning's United Kingdom Talk. And if it's just gone 10 o'clock, then you are with us live. If it's any other time, then you are watching a recording. Greetings and welcome to you all. Look, I've got something new. Was out at the shops yesterday, and my sister actually recommended these body shop oils. Okay, they're not those oils that you do for the massaging. You put them in. I've got this diffuser, which I showed you some weeks ago that my sister got me for my for one of my Christmas presents. And you put this stuff in, just a few drops, and it starts smelling. That the whole place starts smelling. Now you get three little plastic bottles with the actual item itself, which is only about £10-15. I think she got it from Asda Home and Home Base or whatever, Asda something where they sell home things. Asda Home Base maybe, or something like that, I don't know. And you get three with it. There's a vanilla one, which actually isn't very nice. I didn't like the vanilla one. There's eucalyptus, which is nice. And what was the other one? And lavender. Oh, it's lovely lavender. Do you like lavender? Oh, it's a lovely smell. So they come with it. Well, I've finished those now. So I had to go and get some more. And I went to Body Shop yesterday. And I found three flavours here, which I've yet to sample, actually. I've got Satsuma. That's all my sister said to get. Satsuma. So let's have a little smell here. Just a moment, please. Mmm. That's quite nice. Satsuma. Okay, so that's the Satsuma one. Yes. We've got Mandarin and what's that say? Oh, I can't even see the. Why do they make the writing so blooming small? One moment, please. One moment, please. Mandarin and Tangelo. Tangelo? What's Tangelo? Is that tangerine? There must be tangerine. I've never heard of Tangelo. What's Tangelo? One moment, please. I'll look it up. Oh, it's me. Just a moment, please. Oh, just a moment. Mandarin. Sorry. Don't want to listen to myself, do I? What's it again? Tangelo. T-A-N. G-E-L-O. One moment. Tangelo. Oh, it's a citrus. A hybrid of a tangerine and a pomelo or grapefruit. Oh, it's a hybrid. So there's this one. Let's have a little smell of this one. Now, that actually smells like the No, it's not quite. That's nice. So that's Tangelo and Matter. These are from Body Shop. £4. £4 one of these. There you go. Look, quite nice. Can you see that all right? And there's a lower and soft linen. Let's try that one. Oh, that's nice. Oh, well, it's like you're at a nightclub sniffing something, isn't it, boys? And that's quite nice as well. Yes, so we recommend all these ones, all available from the Body Shop, £4 each. So that's three for £12. And they last ages. When I first got this diffuser thing, I'd put a couple of drops in. I went, well, that won't be enough. And honestly, I got through almost half a bottle in one insertion. What do you call it? In one pouring? I don't know what you say. And you honestly don't need it. You're in about four or five drops in there. And the whole house fills with the aroma of whatever you put on it. I wonder if you can get one like it smells like a new car. We do like the smell of new cars, don't we? Yes. Let's say hello to the early people this morning, boys and girls. Your messages are pouring in already. Got millions of messages are pouring in here to the United Kingdom Talk television complex. Good morning this morning to Kevin Webster. Chris, why is the picture so pale? Do you want a bit more colour? The trouble is, now I've got a little bit of a problem with this new camera. And if I have the colour set up too far, the picture starts jumping. And I was talking to my very good friend Ben Parker, who does karaoke nights and DJ and things and sings and all that. He's a lovely man, he is. And he reckons that the camera is sending too much information for the broadcasting software, because you don't see direct from camera. You see from camera to broadcasting software to internet. Whereas usually it's probably just camera to internet. Now, because there's a bit of software in the middle, he thinks that the new camera is overloading it because it's such a high quality one. Now, I will try and turn the colour up for you now, OK? And we'll see what happens. But I think you're going to find the picture starts jumping. If you're watching a recording of the show, that won't happen, OK? It's just for the live viewers. We can try the white balance. She'll turn that up a bit. Does that help? That's a little bit better, isn't it? That's not jumping yet, is it? Okay. So I've turned up the white a little bit. See how that goes. All right, it might start jumping. If it starts jumping, I'll have to turn it down a bit. Let's have a look at myself. See what happens there.
And that goes.
Oh, no. I don't want to listen to myself, please. Is that better? I think you find that's a little bit better, my darlings, all right? See how that goes there, all right? Just a little bit of colour in my poor, pasty old face. I had a lovely friend of mine, Charlotte. She lives on the on the Canary Islands, in Grand Canaria now. And she said I always looked a bit pasty. You're looking a bit pasty today, Chris, she'd say. Oh, dear. OK, Gustav says he's hoping he's twizzled his knob again. Thank you, Gustav. Knob pressed. What it is, I'll explain again, Gustav, is there's no knob to twiddle. There's a button there, OK? Before the show starts, and you get that timer thing, I need to push up a fader to be able to hear that music. Otherwise, I can't hear it. Now, if I have that button pushed down when I hear it, then it hears it and sends it back to the broadcast computer. It goes back and forth, and you get the most awful racket of echoing and everything. So I have to have that button unpressed. A little bit like this shirt, unpressed this morning. Now, when that's finished and I start talking to you, I don't need to have that fader up anymore. So I then need to push that button. Otherwise, the callers come through that same fader. Actually, if I got another sound card, I wouldn't have to do that. But nevertheless, as it is at the moment, the sound have to come through that button, through that fader. And for you to hear it, I have to push the button so it goes in to the broadcast computer. And that's why that has to happen. But I keep forgetting to push the button on the rare occasions that we get callers in. Yes. By the way, there is a phone number, boys and girls, if you want to call in at any time. Please try and know at least what you're calling in about. You know, sometimes old Blakey yesterday, was it Blakey yesterday? And Ross Pat's out. They ring him. Hello, well, what are you calling in about? Oh, well, I don't know. What do you want to talk about? Well, could you have something to actually call in about, you know, rather than say, oh, you know, just ringing to say hello. That is not really of much interest to other people. You have to think of other people. It's nice that you come and ring in and say hello to me, but other people want you to have a little bit more to say than that, dear. All right? Gustav, Shania is at work again. Oh, you poor old soul. You just work and work and work, Shania, don't you? Good morning to Kevin Webster. Have I said hello to you already? Kevin Webster, Rod Brown says, I think we should have a BBC test card picture. Oh, very, very illegal. I couldn't do that, dear. Oh, no, I would have my bum smacked. I would have my bum smacked very hard, hopefully. Good morning to the lovely Elaine. Morning, Elaine. Kevin says, why is the picture so pale? That's why it was pale then, OK. That's the reason for that. Oh, we've got a call coming in already. Oh, just a minute. From London.
Hello.
I'm not sure where you are. Where are you? Hello, good morning.
You all right?
Who's that? Hello?
Hello?
Can you hear me? Speak. No, get rid of that one. Yes, good morning to Duke this morning, who's in his bed. Good morning, Duke. You rang me last night while I was in bed, didn't you? Huh? There I was, just about to go sleepy weepy. But why is it, Duke, when you ring me, you seem to hand me around to all your friends? What's all that about, dear? I thought we'd just have a little private conversation, you and me, while I'm laying in my bed, watching the news on the... I think it was the news I was watching. They didn't have any clothes on anyway. But I was watching the news last night when he rang in, just before I tried to sleep. I didn't sleep too well at all last night, unfortunately. And I know why. It's my own fault. So I did the quiz night last night at the King's Head Theatre Bar. Quiz Oh, Adam, stay there. It's going to happen today, Adam. It's going to happen shortly, OK? I did the quiz night. I do a quiz night every Wednesday night at the King's Head Theatre Bar in Upper Street in Islington. Not bad last night. A little bit quiet again last night. We're having a quiet February. February, March is a bit quiet usually. But we still had five teams, and that was nice. Funnily enough, there was a group of three boys on a table. Now, they've won before. And we got onto the subject of talking about how, you know, why do you live in London? I said, certainly not. No, I don't live in London. And then, like, why is that then? I said, because it's an absolute dump. The whole of London is now an absolute dump. If I didn't work in London, I would not go there. you know? And I said, well, what reasons? I said, well, take your car. If you've got a car, then you've finished from the start, aren't you? Nowhere to park, you know, only driving certain lanes during the daytime. Where do you put the car at night? You know, you pay some greedy council, 150, 200 quid, for the privilege of parking your car, hopefully, outside your front door, but not always if someone else has parked there. Awful. Too many people, it smells, the pollution. No, thank you. I would not want to live in London again. Absolutely not. I honestly think it's a dump. Even when you go through the posh areas, Kensington, Chelsea and all that, you still got all that smog and all those disgusting diesel fumes pouring out of the backs of people's cars. And some people as well, generally by the smell that comes from some of them. I was working at a place last week, actually, and I don't know, I walked in the door and there was this awful smell. It was like someone had been passing wind near the front door. It really was. And you wonder why I don't like people to use my toilet downstairs. God, so after that water bill that I received, which I still haven't paid yet, actually, for £128 for 6 months water bill here, I've decided there's a note on my toilet door now, bring your own flushing water. People will turn, if you want to use my toilet and you're only using it, don't ever think you're going to use the toilet upstairs. It's bad enough knowing that people are using my toilet downstairs. You will never, ever get up those stairs to use my toilet. That is my own private personal toilet. Thank you very much. No one is using that toilet upstairs. Thank you. And if you want to use the one downstairs, you can bring your own bloody water. £128 for flushing the toilet a few times a day. It's outrageous. I'm outraged by that. Anyway, back to the story. So I did my quiz and someone won. Two of the members of staff there, incidentally, Ashley and... oh, I can't remember his name now. Oh, gosh. Ashley and someone else. One of the boys. They're going to be in the new stage version of Fame. You know that one. Fame. I want to live forever. Baby, remember my... Remember. On an electric guitar. My favourite character in the original TV series was the mixed race lady teaching dance. Can't remember what her name was. Was it Debbie? Was it Debbie someone? That might be the name of the actress, though. Debbie someone. Yes. That was my favourite actress in that one. So came out from there and I thought, I feel a bit peckish again. And I thought, well, I won't have a five guys like I did last week because I didn't like the chips. And I mentioned this to one of the bar staff and they said, oh, that's unusual. The chips are usually quite nice in there. Maybe you had a dodgy portion or something like that. So I thought I'll stop in it and I'll get a nice vanilla milkshake for the long, arduous journey home, boys and girls, here to the wilds of Royal Berkshire, just down the road from Queen. Bad news about someone living near the Queen coming up on this programme. Stay tuned, OK? So I pulled round the corner, got to five guys, pulled round the corner, parked up, and I walked over there. And as I got, I might as well have something to eat while I'm here now. So I ordered exactly the same as I did last year, with one slight difference. I ordered, instead of having the normal chips, I had the spicy chips. I had spicy chips and this vegetarian mushroom... thing. I don't know what you call it. Burger? This is a burger without the meat in it. You know, mushroom thing. And a vanilla shake and unlimited Coca-Cola. So I have this and I'm shoving this in my mouth. And it was all very close. And I get there usually around about 15 minutes before it's due to close. And then a boy. And they're always very friendly, the staff. And I was served by a very, very friendly girl. She was ever so nice. What a shame I couldn't understand a bloody word she was saying. I don't know where she was from, dear. Lithuania or somewhere like that. Couldn't understand what she was saying. She had to say everything three times. But never mind, we got there in the end. And I had my meal. And as soon as I got up, I thought, oh, God, that was big. And it weren't any bigger than a normal meal. But I could feel it in my stomach, you know, like it had all been pushed up. And I managed to get back to the car. I sat in the car. Oh, dear me. How much have I eaten there? It was just a normal, same as I had last week. But I didn't have the problem last week. Anyway, got home. I think I was going to do a show last night when I got in, a late night show. But I decided to go straight to bed. So I come upstairs, brush my teeth. Very important to brush your teeth. I hope you brush your teeth every night. I keep bumping into people who don't brush their teeth. Disgusting people. Oh, and the smell that comes out of those mouths when people haven't brushed their teeth. Yes. It's awful. Dreadful. Please do not come up to me in a DJ box or behind while I'm standing behind a table doing a karaoke with unbrushed teeth. Because I will tell you, I will take photographs and post them on Facebook. Keep your disgusting mouths to yourselves. Jello, what's been in half of those mouths to make them smell so awful, dear? Dreadful. So I got home, brushed my teeth, and I went about, and I thought, oh, God. And I could feel all this food weighing in my stomach. It was horrible. And of course, that really mucked up my sleep last night. So I haven't slept particularly well last night. The last few nights, I've slept incredibly well. Only got up once to go to wee the other night. Usually it's twice, sometimes three times. Only once the other night. Did you want to share that piece of information? So I did have quite a bad night's sleep last night, but it was my own fault for having that meal before I got home. The chips I had, incidentally, at Five Guys, I haven't had them before. Spicy chips. Oh, yes. Yum, yum, yum. Very, very tasty. Mmm. Spicy chips with lashings and lashings of tomato sauce. Now, Five Guys, it's not cheap in there. My God. In fact, I would. The bar staff said it is a bit extortionate in there. Let me tell you, I had a mushroom burger. I had medium spicy chips. And I had a Coke and I had a vanilla shake. That was 16 quid. Ooh. I mean, if you're on your own, to be fair, if you're on your own, that's not too bad. But imagine if you're with someone else, well, that would have been 32 quid. Or a family, two children as well. 32, 64 quid that would have been. 64 quid on a family. But for one person, it's not too bad, but it is quite dear there. And I did enjoy it better than I did last time. So it must have been a dodgy portion of chips I had last time. But I mustn't eat before I get home. This is where I'm going wrong. Now, I'm going to start trying to do my little bit of weight loss today, I've decided. And this is how I'm going to do it. I've looked in some of the Slimming World instructions, OK? And one of the things that you can have quite a lot of is bran flakes, fruit and bran, and bananas. So, from today, I'm going to have two breakfasts. I've already had one breakfast today. I had bran flakes, fruit and fibre bran flake type things. I have soya milk on it and a chopped up banana. Now, that's actually quite a lot. The chopped up banana kind of almost doubles what's in the bowl. So I'm going to have two of those and a normal meal. And that's what I'm going to try and do from today. Now, the normal meal could be the lovely sandwiches that Maureen brings me in twice a week. She brings me in sandwiches. I have requested now that Maureen doesn't bring me in any more chocolate because lovely, 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 lovely people keep bringing me in massive bars of chocolate. And I've had to request, please stop bringing the chocolate in. If you bring it, if someone brings me in chocolate, I'm going to have to give it back to them and say, do you mind if I give it out to other people? And it's so hard when they give it to you. That will be a test. That will be a test if someone gives me a bar of chocolate. I just have that bar. Yeah, it's not going to work, is it? You've got to be strict on yourself. So that's it. Now, today on the show, I shall shortly be sampling this Slimmer's World Devour Me Double Choc Crisp Bar that the kind Adam the Plumber has given to me. So that's coming up very, very soon before my tea gets completely cold. Let's say hello to a few more people. Good morning to Tim Partington. Good morning, Britain. Good morning. Good morning, Tim. Hope you're well this morning. I haven't seen you for a while. Do pop into Central Station very soon, Tim. Be nice to have you singing there, sir. Ah, Kevin said the picture's better now. Yeah, we've shoved a bit more colour in there. But it will start jumping if I turn the colour up anymore. I don't see a resolving for that other than to go back to the old camera. And then it's a bit, you know, it's a bit smaller, isn't it? But we'll see how we go with this one. Tim says, how about a test card featuring the United Kingdom Talk logo? Well, yeah, I know what you mean there. I quite like the countdown I've got now. I spent some time doing that. So I hope you like that with the little diamonds that all split up and go to nothing. And then we appear, don't we? Duke says, I just tried to call in. Oh, was that you? Well, why didn't you speak to me, dear? I was saying hello and you wouldn't speak to me. Try again, little Duke. Try again. Good morning to Billy Mac says, I just take my teeth out and wash them. It's much easier. Oh, I'm sure you do, Billy. Oh, how awful. What, under the tap, or do you leave them? Do you actually leave them in the in a glass of water or something like that, do you? Elaine says, are you getting high on your Satsuma oil stuff? Yes, I think I am, actually. Let's have a little sniff of that, yeah. It's better than the glue, isn't it, dear? I did try to do glue sniffing once. Unfortunately, it went shoved straight up there and I couldn't breathe for 3 weeks. It stuck my nostrils together, yes. Right, now let's try some of Adam's... Now, I'm sure I saw an... did I see a message from Adam there somewhere? I'm sure I saw a message from Adam. Where's that gone to? Did you put a message here, Adam? I can't see it now. Oh, there it is. Can I say hi to Dan? Oh, good morning to Dan, who's working with you today. Good morning, Dan. All right, sir. Is that your other half, Dan, or is that someone else? Not sure. Oh, it's a phone call now. There we are. Let's take the call. Good morning.
Good morning.
Who's calling in on Lifeline 77 and a half?
It's the lovely Duke.
Hello, Duke. All right. Are you still in bed?
No, I've just got Jamie up.
Jamie, are you living in with Jamie, are you?
No. We was at Central Station last night.
Right.
Why? Watching Fabulous Sandra.
Watching Sandra? Yeah, but why is he round your ass? Haven't you got jobs to go to, dear?
He's got work.
Eh?
I'm working at home.
Oh, what do you do?
Looking after myself.
Looking after?
Myself.
Yourself?
It's a full-time job.
You're paid to look after yourself, are you?
Yep, self-employed.
Oh, that's outrageous, dear. How can you get that? It was a form for me all to fill out. Can I get money for looking after myself, then? So you're at our wonderful Central... Describe Central Station to the millions of people that are watching this programme at the moment. Thank you.
Say that again.
Eh?
Say that again.
Describe Central Station to the millions of people that are watching us today.
Do I have to be nice?
Of course you have to be nice, dear. Tell us about the beautiful wallpaper that there is.
No, how would you describe Central Station?
Come back towards the phone, dear.
In one word, we describe it as fabulous, as Jamie said.
Fabulous, is that it?
Apparently so. I call it Narnia.
Narnia? Oh, my word. Yeah. You like the peacock wallpaper. Is it peacock or flamingos? Flamingos. You like the you like the flamingo wallpaper, don't you? I bet we'd like a few rolls of that in your room. Whereabouts do you live in London?
I'm sure the posh end.
Oh, so if I was to come there and visit, where would I park for free? There's nowhere, is there?
For free, in Hoxton Square.
There is somewhere, is there?
Yeah.
Oh, well, I beg your pardon.
Right opposite the church, so you can meet for confessions.
I know the church, yes. My mate used to live round the back there in Columbia Road. Do you know it?
Columbia Road, that's Flower Market, isn't it?
That's right, yeah. He used to live round the back there. And I think he had parking spaces, but he had trouble. He had two, his like one parking space, you could get two cars and it was so big. And people would complain that there were two cars in the parking space, even though he had that parking space. Miserable people. I hope you're not the sort of person to pick up the phone and report your neighbours like that indiscriminately, lovey.
No, I also bring my own toilet water as well.
You what?
I also bring my own toilet water as well.
Oh, well, you're welcome to turn up here if you bring your own bucket of water to flush the toilet with. I'm sick to death of people pushing up our water bill. Someone came round here a few weeks ago and they wanted the heating on. I mean, they've heard it all now. Put a bloody jumper on, that's what I say. You know, my niece, Tracey, actually, she's in hospital. She's not very well. She's in hospital at the moment. Anyway, she puts the heating on. Her husband makes her turn it off. He says, put a jumper on. That's true, that is.
It's called economising.
Exactly. We can't afford to put heating on. What have you got, a one-bedroom flat or a room or what?
Masonette, two-bedroom.
And that who lives in there, then?
And Jamie lives in a top-floor apartment.
Oh, does he now? And who's paying for that? Someone a bit older?
He is.
Oh, what does he do, Jamie? What's his job?
He works in a restaurant.
Oh, was he a waiter?
I did want to say Chariots, but it's closed down now.
It's closed down? Oh, that lovely little club. I used to spend so many happy hours in there, not quite knowing what I was doing. That was wonderful in there, that little place. Oh, and they knocked it down. Has it been rebuilt yet? Is it a hotel? Is it? I think it's a hotel, isn't it?
No, it still looked pretty empty. That's when I walked past it.
Oh, they haven't knocked it down yet?
No, next to Jesse Boyd.
Oh, they knock all that. You know, in years to come, Duke, in years to come, this United Kingdom Talk television complex will also be knocked down and probably be replaced by flats. Isn't that awful to know? Well, I should be at the Two Brewers tonight if you want to pop down.
Are you at the Two Brewers? Oh, OK.
I am indeed, all right. I don't know what the show is tonight. Do you want me to find out? Or doesn't it bother you who it is?
I'm not too sure.
One moment, please. I shall now search this for you now in Clapham. Clapham. Oh, it doesn't come up first, you know. That'll upset them.
Did the bridge come up first?
Oh, she's very good. Myra Dubois. Oh, hang on. Is that Wednesday? Yes. Myra Dubois. She's quite good. Have you seen her before?
No.
Drag out. Very good. You're like her. Very rude. You like rude, don't you?
I do love rude.
Thank you for calling in, young Duke.
Thank you, Christopher.
Au revoir.
Au revoir.
Goodbye. There's Duke calling in there from Shoreditch. That is a horrendously expensive place in London. And you wouldn't want to live there. It's a dump. I'm sorry. It's a dump, lovey. That's it. Now, just a moment. Let me just put that name in there, dear. OK. Right, it's time for the sampling. Good morning to Joey Millen. Good morning, Joey. Your item is on its way. It was posted yesterday, Johnny. Good morning to Mr. Ray Reynolds. Widescreen picture today. This is a CinemaScope television presentation. Thank you, Ray. Here we are. Right, Adam. Adam bought me in these Slimmer's World chocolate bars. Double choc crisp. So it's now time to sample one live on this programme in front of the millions of people that are joining us today. One moment, please. Here we go. I actually don't feel very hungry at the moment. Isn't that funny? We're just going to have one little bite and I shall be able to... Let me stack. The bin is over there just in case I need to spit it out. One moment. Now, how many calories in one of these then? You know, that's not bad. It's got like a toffee-ish taste to it. That is not bad at all. That really isn't bad. Now, I'm not going to eat it all. Not because I don't like it. I just don't feel hungry at the moment. I've just had my breakfast. That is not bad at all, Adam. Now, I'll put that there for later on. I'll have that for pudding. I'll have that for my pudding. Let's have a look here. So, per 20 gram, but what is only 70 calories in one of those? Look, 70 calories in one of those. So that's very good, isn't it? Slimming World. How much is a box of these then? I bet they're really dear. Slimming World. We're trying to lose a bit of weight, Duke. Well, I am anyway, Duke and Jamie. Did I miss a call then? Sorry, Elaine. Do you want to try that again? I wasn't looking at the screen. Sorry, Elaine. Give us another call back there. They aren't bad at all, those. We are trying to lose a little bit of weight. You know, I'm trying to become more attractive to people. It's very, very hard at my age to try and become more attractive to people. People like Elaine, who was just trying to call in there. Call in again, Elaine. In Israel, are naturally attractive. In fact, most of the viewers watching this particular programme, unless my sister's watching it, because she's not very attractive at all. Most of the viewers watching this programme are very, very attractive. But I'm afraid I'm not. And I need to lose a stone, possibly a stone and a half in weight, so that once again, I can go out to nightclubs and take my top off and dance all night long with other people looking at me thinking, poor, I'll have some of that. That's what needs to happen. And the only way to do it is to lose weight, dear. And then I might have some dots put in my head to cover the bald spot on my head as well that people like to moan about all the time. Thank you very much. Oh, Adam's the £1.75 a box. That's not bad. Adam, I like very much, Adam. Thank you very much for those. I shall now start eating those as part of my calorie-controlled diet. Oh, yes. Now, let me just have a little bit of cold tea. Ah, there's Elaine now. Just a moment. Good morning, Elaine. How are you today, darling? All right?
Good morning. How are you?
Oh, Elaine, my tea's gone cold. Oh! Oh, God.
What?
My tea has gone cold.
Oh, I wish I could warm it.
Oh, right. No, I can't drink that now. Oh, that's horrible. Oh, can you
Listen,
drink...
I have such exciting news for you.
Oh, go on.
Do you remember the last time we talked?
Yes.
You must have been psychic or something.
I am a very psychic person. I generally know, Elaine, what's going on everywhere at all times. That is me, yes.
Oh, well, in that case, I'm very glad that I'm dressed.
What is the exciting news? Do tell us, Elaine.
Well, the station manager called me yesterday. They were very impressed with the Barry Manilow show, and they offered me my own weekly radio show.
I told you, didn't I? I told
yes, you. Yes, you did.
And you wanted that, but you didn't ring them, did you, like I told you to?
No, I didn't. They rang me.
I knew you were going to say that. I knew you were going to say that. Congratulations, Elaine. She's got her own radio show in Israel. Israel. Oh, I love Israel. Do you know, I'd like to take someone to Israel, although I'm not very good going on holiday with people. What are you like going on holiday with people, Elaine?
Well, it depends who the person is, but I usually like to go on vacation by myself.
Yes.
Unless it's a really, really close friend.
Yeah.
Because I'm not easy to handle on vacation. I have my own thing.
Now, this is me. Elaine, this is me. Unfortunately, it is my best mate as well. And one was okay. I've been to Rome with him. I've been on a cruise with him, and there was another one somewhere, and all three have ended up in terrible rows and things. And I said, no, it isn't. We can't do this again. And I just won't go on holiday with him again.
That's a problem. You really have to be compatible with the person that you're going with.
I'm not saying that it's all his fault. I'm not saying it's all my fault. It's just a mismatch there of people to go on holiday with. The best holiday I ever took someone away with was with my nephew. But, you know, it's kind of... I mean, he was 17 at the time. But to me, he's still a little boy that needs to be looked after. Do you know what I mean? And it's like... although he... You know, I remember going out one night. I was going to the Barry Manilow concert in Florida, in Orlando one night. And I said, well, you stay in a room. Whatever you do, don't go outside the room. He said, oh, come on, Chris, I'm 17 now. I said, make sure you stay in a room and lock the door.
You're a bad uncle.
I was so worried that something was going to happen to him. And that's probably why it worked, because it was like someone to look after. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So that was the best holiday I had when I took someone away. And of course, I'm with my mum and dad and used to go on holiday with the scouts and all this business. Yeah.
Well, that's okay. Well, when you get here, we'll do lovely things together and we'll have a great time.
Okay, Elaine, that's lovely, darling. Now, your line is not very good today. You're kind of waving in and out a little bit, I think. Don't know why that is.
Yeah. Well, I'm a jerk anyway, so I can't really stay long. I just have to tell you this news.
Well, that is fantastic news. Do you know when your show is starting?
Yes, I'm starting on the beginning of March.
Beginning of March,
I'll let you know the date.
Excellent. Please do. I'm still waiting for your link to the show. Did you put that on my
wall? Yes, I put it on Barry Manilow's Facebook.
Oh, put it on my wall as well, please, so everyone can see it, darling, all right?
Okay, I will.
Congratulations, Elaine. Bye-bye, darling.
Thank you, Chris.
Bye,
have
love.
A good day.
Bye. There we are. Elaine in Israel. She's got her own radio show now. That's excellent, isn't it? Excellent, excellent news. Well done, Elaine. Very, very good indeed. Call in if you want to. 020-8144-3477 is the phone number. Or you can use Skype if you've got Skype. Our Skyping username is all one word, United Kingdom Talk. Okay, all one word, United Kingdom Talk. Right, back to your messages. Hello to JoAnna. Oh, JoAnna, are you still in hospital, darling? You're with us live today. How fantastic is that? JoAnna says... Please tell Lady E, who was just on the phone there, she did a wonderful job on her Manilow special. There we go. All right? They all loved your Manilow special, which I have yet to listen to. I shall download it and put it, if I can, onto my iPhone Music. Oh, yes, because we're on the new iPhone now. Yes, the iPhone SE, as purchased from that lovely young lady. What was her name? Camilla? I think her name was Camilla. I got one of those surveys, and I usually don't fill out those surveys. You know, every time you ring up someone now, you get a survey through the email. Oh, could you tell us how we did? One star for this. Anyway, but I filled it out, and I give her a good old write-up, because she was very, very good, the girl. Her name, once again, Camilla, I think her name was, or Cam, who works in the Apple shop in Reading. Oh, yes, JoAnna is indeed still in hospital. Well, I hope you're going to get out of there soon, JoAnna, darling. And I'll show you what I've got here, JoAnna, just a moment while you're there. I'm going to send you another one of those items, right? But this time it's going to be in one of these. Okay, I'm going to put it in one of these because I sent JoAnna an item and I've nearly run out of the things now as well. Oh, that's not going to come off there. I cannot reveal my address to you, JoAnna, darling. One moment, please. I have to cross all that out there. Oh, that's him. I can't show this on the programme, dear, because people start turning up. Yeah, if I put my address on here, people start turning up, and they don't knock at your door. They kind of get little camps outside my house. You know, we want Chris. We want Chris. And I have to open the window. It's a bit like having the paparazzi, you know. I mean, I'm always worried that, you know, the paparazzi will turn up at my front door and then I'll have to go into my car, you know. And you know what happened to Diana? You know, it's all very worrying. I do go down a couple of underpasses. You don't know what's down there, do you? Who's calling in now, please?
Good morning, Chris.
Good morning. Who's that?
It's Joey's girlfriend.
Is it Stacey, Joey's girlfriend? Up in Preston. Is it up in Preston?
Yeah.
And what's it like living up in Preston, Stacey? What's it like living up there?
Well, I mean, yeah.
Is it lovely? Nice, is it like a little? Is it like a little village with a duck? Oh,
no,
just a moment. I've just noticed something's not plugged in properly here. Oh, God. Honestly, it's whatever. There's always something wrong, isn't there? Oh, I didn't have something plugged in there, which means the sound on the recording isn't going to be very good. Oh, God's sake, it always goes so badly wrong, Stacey. Yeah, is it like a little village with a duck pond and a church that plays bells on a Sunday?
No, Preston's city, we're like 10 minutes away from the town centre, which is actually quite good.
It's nice there. Is there plenty to do at night? You know, little pub on the street corner with its own... with its own children's play area and perhaps another pond within the pub and church bells on a Sunday morning and nice people walking about. Is that what Preston is like, lovey? Is it? Is it?
Yeah.
That's what it's like, is it? Yeah. Is it somewhere that I'd like to visit? Is there a caravan park there?
I'm not actually too sure. I'll have to find out from Joe. But there's always one at Blackpool.
Blackpool. Is that like lots of... That's where I have all the sparkling lights. Haven't you got that massive roller coaster there, Stacey?
In Blackpool there is, yeah. It's
you have?
The big one.
Oh, my word. Have you been on that?
No.
Oh, no. I don't think I could go on that, Stacey. No, thank you very much. I don't do roller coasters in the best of times, dear.
No.
Awful.
Like... No, wouldn't I don't like fair rides myself because of what I've read in the news. It's put me off a bit.
Oh, what have you read in the news then, lovey?
I think there was this ride in, China or Japan. This teenage girl got thrown from the ride onto the metal.
I know.
Onto the metal railing.
Oh, it's awful. There's no way I would go on one of those rides. I think I've been on two roller coasters, both of them in Disney. I went on this, the yellow train. I can't remember what that's called now. And Space Mountain. Never again, dear. Oh, horrendous. They had a little children's one there as well. They've got a little children's one that might be at Universal in Florida, I think. And I went on that and I was frightened on that one. I was scared on that one as well. And you're thrown out of this little truck, dear. But people go on that. They like the thrill of thinking that they're going to die. What's all that about?
Facing the fear, I think.
Why not just go straight to it, buy yourself a gun and shoot yourself, if that's what you like? You know, if you're going to get a thrill out of that.
Yeah, it's true. It's like Russian roulette, isn't it?
Oh, well, Stacey. Well, thanks for calling. Is there anything else you wanted, darling?
I just wanted to say hello, Chris, and say hello to everybody that's obviously watching, and to tell you that... keep up the good work. Me and Joe watch your shows on a daily basis and we love them.
Oh, thank you. I am here to bring a little bit of sparkle into your life, Stacey, darling. That's why I'm here, sparkling away and flashing like a fairy light.
Oh, that's good. All right, then, Chris, I'll speak to you later.
Cheerio, Stacey. Bye-bye.
Okay, bye.
Bye, love. There we are. Stacey calling in from the beautiful village of Preston in Lancashire. I think it's Lancashire, yes. Just a moment. Stacey, where is it now? Stacey. There we are, that's that done. Add that there. I like to know who's a bit hard. See, if I put your name in, then I know when you're calling in again. All right. Yes, so I've got this big envelope, and I shall be putting your item into this big envelope there. Just a moment, please. Let me just cross this out. I'll cross that out there. And we'll get that. I should be able to get that off to you today or tomorrow. All right, JoAnna. Dispatch too. I like that word, dispatch. Do you like that word, dispatch? One moment, there we are. There we are. It'll go in this nice big envelope. Look at that, and I'll wrap it around. So hopefully it won't be broken this time by the customs people in the United States, all right? Alan says, good morning. Good morning to Alan Russell. Russell, who popped in to the King's Head Theatre Bar last night, but didn't do the quiz. He just sat there, didn't you, dear? You should do the quiz. I'm sure you're a very intelligent person, Alan. Much more intelligent than myself, anyway. Good morning to JoAnna again. Thanks for sending another. Was very depressed. The other item was in a million... Oh, was that what it was, JoAnna? Is that what made you go to hospital? I sent her something in the post and it broke when it got there. She was so upset about the whole thing, she had to go to hospital about it. And she's having treatment now. Item sent from Chris Reardon arrives in a million pieces due to the inconsistencies of the security people in the United States, dear. Customs and excise. You know, it's only a blooming little thing. We're not like, it's not like we're shoving drugs and guns and nuclear weapons through the post to JoAnna's house, is it, dear? God's sake. Where are we? I've lost there. There we are. So it's on its way now. Okay, it will be on its way later on today, my darling. I think you sent me a private message with the thing. Now, talking of messages, there's some more messages now coming in from yesterday's show, boys and girls. JoAnna says, I must say, as I speak, the nurses and doctors are laughing and now clapping to their acknowledgement because she's got all the nurses watching the show now. Hello, nurses and doctors. Very important people. You don't get enough money. Nurses and doctors don't get enough money. You should have blank checks given to you, doctors and nurses. Absolutely, yes. Let me tell you, from what JoAnna says, nurses and doctors, I would want to be in that hospital. But here in the NHS, it's all free. If I'm ill, I just go into hospital. I haven't got to pay anything. Isn't that marvellous? Yes. Although some people take the mick. They do. They're like, oh, I've cut my finger. I must go to casualty. Don't be so pathetic. Oh, I've got sore throat. Must go to casualty. No, you mustn't. You must stay at home and not bother the services. That's why we can't cope at the moment. They are bursting at the seams at casualty. A little bit like my trousers, to be honest. Oh, dear. Must lose this weight. Must lose this way. Perhaps, JoAnna, do the doctors in your hospital, could I go there and have this fat cut off me? I mean, it would be so much easier. There'd be quite a lot of it. You know, you could sell it possibly to a Chinese restaurant or a fish and chip place, and you could use my fat once it's been melted down to do people's chips in. Why not recycle? It's all about recycling now, dear. All about recycling. Yes. Joanna says, they love the show and find you very hilarious. They get me up on two different shifts and bring me out to nurse's station and we watch your programme. Oh, dear. Well, it's better than the American television, isn't it? God, so how long does it take to watch a programme? Those of you in the UK, never been to America, let me tell you how the television is in America, right? So you know the little bits at the beginning of the show. So, for example, if it's on BBC One, now on BBC One, it's time for, I don't know, it's time for Let It Shine. And they run the credit, Let It Shine, and then they have adverts. And then there's 2 minutes of the programme, and then they have adverts. And then there's another 2 minutes, and then they have adverts. And at the end of the show, Gary Barlow, or whoever it is, to say, thank you very much for watching, goodbye. Then they have adverts, and then they have the credits. My God, there's so many adverts. American and Australian. Australian telly is similar to that. It's awful. The way it's just thrown together is just dreadful. So I can understand how well they're enjoying this programme. Without any adverts, I'm not selling anything today. Not even this Dalek. Now, I've had this Dalek, Joanna, for some time now. Years, actually. About 4, 5, 6 years. And the other day, it was here. It was here. And I picked it up here. And I didn't even know it did this. Watch.
You would make a good Dalek.
I would make a good Dalek. Let's have another one. And he says that. And I didn't know it did this. I just happened to pick it up like that. And I pushed the button.
Exterminate. You are an enemy of the Daleks.
That's
you
my...
must be destroyed.
That's my favourite one. That's my favourite one. You are an enemy of the Daleks. You must be destroyed. Destroy. Destroy. I love it. One more.
You would make a good Dalek.
Do I look like a Dalek? Aren't they fabulous Daleks? We love it. Oh, what's that at the bottom there? It's got something at the bottom as well, eh? What that does. Oh, nothing. Okay. No, that doesn't do anything. So there's my Dalek over there for you. Back to the message. Joanna says, I must say that no matter how I'm feeling, you can always put a smile on my face and make me laugh. You need to be tickled. That's what it is. If you're unhappy, you go to that nurse's station and request that they do tickling. Tickling should be available on the NHS. I think I'd be very good at it. I've got very, very long fingers. Very, very long fingers to tickle you, yes. The same seems to go with the hospital staff here, including my doctors. They put a smile on her face. That's what it's all about. Smiling is a great healer, I believe. They are now big loyal watchers here in the hospital of the global international megastar, Chris Reardon. That's me. That's me, lovey. They all send you their wishes and they need more people like you. I told them one is all I can handle. Do you think so, Joanna? Thank you, Joanna, darling. Let's go to the phone. Ray Reynolds is on the line from London. Good morning, Ray. And they need more
people.
Ray.
Hello.
Good morning, Ray. How are you?
How are you? That's strange you should pick up that dialect. I just went to the kitchen.
Yes.
And picked up exactly the same model. And I thought, I wonder if it still works. And I pressed it a few times, nothing. And then all of a sudden... And all of a sudden it started working.
Oh, is it the same as mine? It's got a little clock on the front as well. Yes! They're talking to each other. They're talking to each other. We love them. I love it. Put that back on there, darling.
How strange is that? You and I have got so much in common, we're absolutely nuts.
I'd just like to point out that you're the common one, I'm not the common one, dear.
Do you mind? Well, isn't that strange? I have got a larger dialect than this that I also got from the charity shop, but that has stopped working, but it was bigger, and it used to move along.
A remote control. I had the same one in the garden. Actually, Justin bought it for me. And I don't know, it's one of those things that you use it a couple of times, isn't it?
And then I put it
in the garden, yeah. And it was all right, but then it started falling apart, and, you know, I lost an eye. Not one of my own eyes, the eye of the Dalek. And after that, of course, the poor thing couldn't see after that, Ray.
I must be honest, this Dalek, it needs a wash. It's been in the kitchen, and it's got a sort of a film on it.
If you don't mind me saying so, Ray, I think you could do yourself at the same time, dear.
I knew that was coming. I walked straight into that. You look very smart in your dark suit today.
Oh, thank you very much. My dark blue jacket today is,
I used to wear a similar suit when I was a bank messenger in 1963.
That's the year I was born, Ray. 1963.
Really? I was 15 then.
Gosh. It's a long time ago now, isn't it, eh?
Unbelievable.
Gosh, well, I forgot to plug the sound into the recording camera today.
I noticed you said that.
Oh,
yeah,
so that's going to create...
That's on the playback.
Well, I can get it back down, but it's a lot of mucking around. It really is.
Why is that picture slightly wider this morning? Even more wallpaper showing.
No, it's not. No, but it's there's not so much colour in it. There's something wrong somewhere. Where if I turn the colour up too much on the camera, it starts jumping all over the place, and I can't work out why it's doing that. My friend Ben Parker says it's because it's a very high quality camera. It's overloading the software. It's like, you know, you're turning up the sound too loud and it starts
just
distorting.
A bit too much.
Yeah. So
like my good self.
It's all right on the recording camera, but not the live one. I don't know why that is, really.
No, my picture quality is very good. I must say you've improved immensely. I mean, it was very good in the first place, but you have improved.
It's all about permanently improving one's things.
Yeah.
I just wish I could improve my face.
Yeah. Well, you're
never mind.
We can't see below the desk.
Eh?
We can't see below the desk, thank God.
No, good job. I don't bother below here. Sometimes I'm naked while I'm sitting here from the waist downwards.
Oh, no, I've heard stories like that at the BBC, yes.
Oh, I'm sure they are. God knows what Angela Rippon had underneath their desk, dear. Well, we saw it, didn't we, on the Morecambe and Wise show years ago. When she did that news, she was reading the news and then the desk opened and then she started dancing with the lovely Morecambe and Wise.
That must have been shown about a million times.
And not enough. There should be their own TV channel, the Morecambe and Wise channel, I reckon. That's what
I heard you say that. Actually, yeah, that's very good, yeah. They have tried things like that in the past, but...
Do you think I should have my own satellite channel, Ray, where it just permanently shows my shows? What do you think?
Well, yeah, aren't they all available? If you go searching for them,
yes. But there are people in places like Africa who don't have internet services, darling. You know, I'm thinking, you know, if I could get myself on a satellite somewhere, then we could be even more global than we are now, lovey. In fact... I could be transmitted from the transponders from the Hubble telescope and Voyagers 1 and 2 to outer space. Just imagine, aliens
like
would be watching
word,
this
Hubble.
Programme. There's a few now, I think.
Goonhilly Downs.
Goonhilly.
Goonhillies.
That's like your ass, that is. I've got to tell people, Ray Reynolds, he's got one of those motorised 10 metres dishes in his garden. And he pushes a button and he goes, and it looks at another side. The neighbours hate
bird,
him.
Astra, hot bird.
Yeah, the neighbours hate him, don't they? The neighbours absolutely hate him, they do.
Yeah. You'll be very surprised when I pick up, but that's another story.
I'm sure you do. Thank you, Ray.
Okay, all the best.
Cheerio now.
See you soon.
Yes, I'll see you tomorrow. All right, darling.
Take care, bye.
The lovely Ray Reynolds calling in from London there, boys and girls. How marvellous. Right, we're due today's birthdays. Oh, I'll just do some more messages here for you. And then we'll do today's birthdays and then we'll disappear. Good morning to Sean Michael Crabtree, who says, my face is lovely. Oh, not if I get close up. You can see the lines, lovely. Look. Oh, look at those. My God, look at them there now. They're getting more and more. Oh, I could have little dots there to join dot to dot. Johnny Key, Ray was 15 in 1863, not 1963. Thank you, Johnny Key. Yes, I thought that was the case, but I didn't like to say anything. You said it, Johnny, not me. You're the one who's going to get into trouble, my friend. Naughty Johnny Key. And Joanna says, Thank you for the great tickle. That's all right. That's all right. We like to do a tickle now and again. Hello to Steve Evans, who's watching this morning, possibly sitting next to Adam in his little plumbing van. Adam is a famous plumber. Adam will travel anywhere in London and the South East to fix your pipes. Actually, Adam's done work for Ray Reynolds as well. He will not rip you off. There's no service charge. In fact, he gets in a little bit of a money situation sometimes, don't you, Adam, dear? Because you haven't got enough of it, dear. You need to put your prices up. Not to me, obviously, but to other people. All right. Good. Right, let's do today's birthdays, boys and girls. Where are the birthdays? One moment, please. Selecting birthdays. And then and then I'll have a listen to the playback on the recording camera. If I can't hear it properly, I'll have to spend some time doing the getting the audio back down from the line. But it's an easy thing to do, but it's kind of time consuming. You've got to download it in real time. So what I would have to do is play the live show back to myself and re-record the audio. I don't think I can get the whole file down, but I'll have a go anyway. Happy birthday today to James Dean. James Dean is 42 years old today. Now, James, darling, James, lovely, he was once a happy little radio person like me on internet stations where he had no holds were barred and he used to do his own show. But unfortunately, he became one of those radio people, boys and girls, with statistics and spreadsheets and worrying about target service areas. He moved from a artistic person like myself, artistic person, pushing the boundaries of television production all over the world, to a generic radio station manager. Haven't you, lovey? Oh, well, James, not to worry, darling. You've become one of them. Yes, you do the job, but where is the excitement now, James? Where is the excitement of not knowing what you're going to do next, lovey? It's all there on the bit of paper, isn't it, darling? 12 o'clock news, 12:02, run advert for that, 12:03, talk for 22 seconds about the weather. 12:04, station strapline and identification. 12:05, play ABBA, Dancing Queen. 12:07, play... That's how it is at real radio stations. That's not a joke. That's not a joke. That is how it is. It's all written down there and it's so boring. Nothing is left to chance, is it, little James? No, dear. It's so goddamn boring. Have you listened to Heart or Capital? Yeah, you're listening to Heart, Britain's Better Music Mix and all that old tosh, dear. God's sake, man. Leave something to chance. Oh, no, no, we can't leave anything to chance. Something might go wrong. Oh, no, 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 no. Thank God I never got into radio. I can't think of anything more boring to do. But happy birthday, James. You are still my friend, and I'm not going to hold that against you, lovey, OK? Happy birthday to David R. Bone. Happy birthday, David. Now, which David are you? I'm sure... Ah, there you are. Happy birthday, David. I recognise you, darling. Always nice when you turn up. You don't turn up much now to places. I don't think you do karaoke. You do more dancing and all that. Happy birthday today to Sandy Clifford. 58 years old today. Happy birthday, Sandy, darling. And Iain Kroll. It's Iain Kroll's birthday today. Let's have a... Which one's Iain? Iain. Oh! Oh, it's Iain. Hello, Iain. Oh, I used to work with him, didn't I? Look at you. Why have you got a pig's head on there, dear? Oh, that's a bit scary, that head. Oh, no, I don't like that, Iain. The pig's head is just scaring me. Happy birthday to you as well, all right? Let's do the song. There it is. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, James, David, Sandy and Iain. Happy birthday to you. All right, gang. Have a nice day on your birthday, okay? That's it from me today. Thank you very much for joining us on our little live show this today. If you're waiting for the recording, it might take a lot longer than it usually does, because I think I'm going to have, unless I pushed that little lead in far enough, because it was in but not pushed right in. If it was pushed right in, it won't take me so long. But if it wasn't, I'm going to have to re-download all the audio and put it all back together again in my video program. All right, thanks so much for watching and listening today. I'll be doing a little bit of DJing tonight, as it's Thursday night. That's at the Two Brewers in Clapham with cabaret from Myra Dubois, and she'll be on stage at 12 midnight. See you again soon. Enjoy your Thursday. Bye bye now. Good morning. It's Thursday, the 9th of February, 2017. Welcome along to this morning's United Kingdom Talk. And if it's just gone 10 o'clock, then you are with us live. If it's any other time, then you are watching a recording. Greetings and welcome to you all. Look, I've got something new. Was out at the shops yesterday, and my sister actually recommended these. Body Shop oils, okay? They're not those oils that you do for the massaging. You put them in. I've got this diffuser, which I showed you some weeks ago that my sister got me for my for one of my Christmas presents. And you put this stuff in, just a few drops, and it starts smelling. The whole place starts smelling. Now, you get three little plastic bottles with the actual item itself, which is only about £10-15. I think she got it from Asda Home and... Home Base or whatever, as to something where they sell home things, as to Home Base maybe, or something like that, I don't know. And you get three with it. There's a vanilla one, which actually isn't very nice. I didn't like the vanilla one. There's eucalyptus, which is nice. And what was the other one? And lavender. Oh, it's lovely lavender. Do you like lavender? Oh, it's a lovely smell. So they come with it. Well, I've finished those now. So I had to go and get some more. And I went to Body Shop yesterday. And I found three flavours here, which I've yet to sample, actually. I've got Satsuma. That's all my sister said to get. Satsuma. So let's have a little smell here. Just a moment, please. Mmm. That's quite nice. Satsuma. Okay, so that's the Satsuma one. Yes. We've got... Mandarin and... What's that say? Oh, I can't even see the... Why do they make the writing so blimmin' small? One moment, please. One moment, please. Mandarin and Tangelo. Tangelo? What's Tangelo? Is that tangerine? There must be tangerine. I've never heard of tangerine. What's Tangelo? One moment, please. I'll look it up. Oh, it's me. Just a moment, please. Oh, just a moment. Mandarin. Sorry. I don't want to listen to myself, do I? What's it again? Tangelo. T-A-N... G-E-L-O. One moment. Tangelo. Oh, it's a citrus. A hybrid of a tangerine and a pomelo or grapefruit. Oh, it's a hybrid. So there's this one. Let's have a little smell of this one. Now, that actually smells like the No, it's not quite. That's nice. So that's Tangelo and Matter. These are from Body Shop. £4. £4 one of these. There you go. Look, quite nice. Can you see that all right? And there's a lower and soft linen. Let's try that one. Oh, that's nice. It's like you're at a nightclub sniffing something, isn't it, boys? And that's quite nice as well. Yes, so we recommend all these ones, all available from the Body Shop, £4 each. So that's three for £12. And they last ages. When I first got this diffuser thing, I'd put a couple of drops in.